Hello everyone, let me show you how we install this free simulator about the ship and the many systems that are on board of a ship. Let me start to be perfectly honest to you, I'm not a naval engineer, I'm just an IT guy, but I love to figure out how things work. And this is a really interesting and detailed simulator with a lot of buttons for me to think about how things work. I will make separate videos about how I think all these systems work and connect to each other, but the main reason for this video is how to show how you get your hands on this free simulator. Let me close the simulator for now. Most important, I need to show props to Adventure Story. He has terrific videos and he is a professional about how systems works on a ship and the many simulators he found. I will put the link in below, but this is the website where you can download the simulator. Don't be afraid, standard the website is in Chinese, but in the top right corner you can switch it to English. You need to make a free account because you need to login data to start up the simulator. Just use this register button, put it on email verification and fill in the form. You will receive an email very shortly with your password to link to the site and simulator. You can download the simulator via this button, but I need to warn you, this is a very slow website and it will take a lot of time. After you download the simulator and you unpack it, the simulator will automatically update itself. You need to run the terminal part, it will put an icon on your desktop, and the first time it will ask you login data, that's why you need to make an account. This program has 10 rooms, you can switch room by the end icon, blue icon. Right now I am room 9, and this is all the classes of room 9. You can run the simulator solo, this is the first button, or with multiple people and team. I didn't use this option, so I cannot say how it works. In a class, you can choose which sim ship you will use in the simulator. Before you can do that, you have to download them with this button on the top side. You can download them with this blue green icon. Again, it will take a very long time. Standard, it uses this ship. For some weird reason, this doesn't work on my PC, because I run into a problem that I cannot use the emergency power to power up the emergency compressor. Let me know in the comments if you find the same problem or if it works on your PC. So I just choose a vessel that works for me. And now I go into this room via this button. And you see, this is the account that I created on the website. Beside my name, there are 3 PC icons. The middle one is a 2D and the right one is a 3D. These two are the representations of the simulator. These parts talk to the first part, the M part. You can see this as a brain part. And the M part will be all the calculations of the simulator, and these two are used to just visualize the simulator. The easiest way to start up this vessel is hit this start button. You see, first it starts the M part and then the 2D part. The first time you start up a ship, you will get several firewall notices because these two parts are talk to each other locally on your PC and your firewall needs to allow that. This is the end part, the brain part. You don't need this for anything, but it must run. Just minimize it. And this is the 2D part. You've noticed there is always a blinking green light that receives data. It receives data because the end part sends data to it. That's the part that you need to configure your firewall to make this communication work. There is a slightly other way to start the simulator. Let me first close this one. You don't actually need to go to and do a class. Let me go out to it. You will need to run this part of the simulator because this has a login and your FLIR licenses. But you can also use this icon again that goes to the screen where you download the vessels, and you can use the end icon, the local directory. Now you go to your hard drive where you see all the vessels you've downloaded. Again, you have here the two parts, the M part and the 2D part. If you go to the M directory and you run the execute file as administrator, you get again this screen and start up the second part, the visualization part. And you see again these two parts are communicating to each other on your PC without actually going into a room. This isn't completely offline because this part will need connection to the internet to verify your login account, but you can run it more privately like you want without going into a room.